do you think about this? So our fertility rate is huge. And I sort of pulled up statistics because, you know, I like me some numbers. And it's apparently it's 4.1%, which means that in urban spaces, families are, people are having at least 3 children. And in rural areas, people are having at least 4. And your statistics are so funny, na, because it says 4.5 children, as if you could have a half child. So do you feel like from when you began your practice to now, do you sort of feel like there has been this shift? More babies are indeed being born.
Yeah, exactly. You know, if you look at the statistics, according to Pakistan Demographic and Health Survey, the recent population of Pakistan is more than 207 million.
Yes, that's a huge number.
It's almost double in the last 30 years.
Oh.
And no doubt, nowadays, we are the sixth most populous country in the world. And if we are not going to control it in 2050, it's going to be the fourth most populous country of the world. And but the bad thing is that the contraceptive prevalence rate in Pakistan is only 34%.
Yes, which is very low.
Very low. Oh. The health professionals in 2012, they made a commitment by the name of Family Planning 2020.
Yes.
It meant that by the year 2020, we shall increase the contraceptive prevalence rate to 55%.
Oh, okay.
But instead,
it's already 2020.
So we have entered 2020, but still, instead of increasing the contraceptive prevalence rate, you will be astonished that the contraceptive prevalence rate has rather decreased.
More?
So it was 35 in the last survey, and in the later survey, it has decreased to 34%.
Oh no!
Yes,
but
of course.
Why?
There are multiple factors for this, and I think it's a huge responsibility. Yes. So being a health professional and especially being a gynecologist.
And you know, I was reading about this, and Pakistan was one of the early countries to adopt family planning practices and to have a kind of system like this began in the 50s.
Yeah.
There was an awareness and there was a recognition that, you know, okay, population control is something that we need to be doing. And, you know, the Family Planning Association was set up and... It's not like we aren't aware of these things.
Yeah, there is an unmet need of family planning. Mm. There is 17% women who want to have contraception and birth spacing, but unfortunately, the means of contraception and they are not, you know, easily available in Pakistan, and they don't have access to those family planning methods.
Right.
And there are multiple factors which are responsible for this. We can say that first of all is the lack of easy accessibility.
Right.
Then there is lack of education and lack of counseling by the health professionals. So I will say that everyone, even LHVs or community health workers or gynecologists, obstetricians who are delivering babies, I think it's our topmost priority to do counseling of the mothers during antenatal period and especially at the time of childbirth, that we counsel them that they have to limit their family size, they have to adopt birth spacing, and when we discharge them from the hospital, we should, you know, put on some sort of contraception or advise them.
This is
the only way because they are very receptive.
They
have recently delivered a baby and they are very receptive at that time.